Someone says, not everything that is faced can be changed, but nothing can be changed until it's faced. And we believe that first-person stories are really important to create connections across difference and to talk about sometimes issues or specific topics that may be hard to bring up or may be hard for others to understand. And it is our hope through writing, through community theater, and through community voice and activism that we can lift these voices up and help tell the broader story.
So, I finished work, I've been assigned, and I heard a couple more shots. Whenever I heard those shots, I started crawling around, looking for my bag, so I could put my tools away and I could leave. I didn't realize I'd been hit until I tried to walk. That's when I put a towel to my leg. Once I was hit, I knew I didn't want to get hit again, so I had my gun out and ready.
Was there no one around to help?
No. Everyone was busy firing back. So there I was, limping around, my hand on my leg, which hurt like hell. I was so pissed. And my gun out and I was yelling, "You mother effers, you shot me! You better not shoot me again!"
Son, remember when you first told me you wanted to join the Marines instead of the Army?
Yes, sir. I was 17 and I was intent on going.
Remember when you told me why?
Yeah. I wanted to join the Marines because I knew the Marines would teach me what I need to know to survive.
Did it, son? Did it teach you?
Bet your ass it did. I'm proud to say I'm a veteran of the United States Marines.
That's good, son. I'm happy it did. I love you.
I love you too, Pop.
Wow. She really is perfect. Ever since I met her, I knew there was something special about her. She really is the most beautiful woman I've ever seen in all my days. If I could get just one dance with her, I think she would realize we were meant to be. George, would you mind if we cut in?
Yeah, sure.
Spiker, and this guy was unfortunately...
What did the tea the first house taste like?
Tastes like tea.
Tea. What did the tea the second house taste like?
Tea.
Tea. What did the tea of the third house taste like?
Tea.
Tea. The tea of the fourth house, the fifth house, and the sixth house are going to taste like tea. The tea of all these houses on our patrol is going to taste like freaking tea. These people don't have a lot of money or resources to their name, and you're stopping at every house basically begging for a cup of tea. If one of these people tips off the enemy because you took the last of their water to make a cup of tea for a soldier, we could get on bad terms. Obviously, we made it back safely, or you've not heard the story today. What should have been a 3-hour patrol turned into a 7.5-hour debacle. To our great relief, the replacement Amtrak arrived just as night was falling. We even made it back in time for supper. But the risks of not having been rescued that day were very real. Those damn camel spiders would have been all over us, for one thing. The risk of dehydration was another. Who knows what else could have been lurking? Like I said before, the Army is not a vacation. You never stop, you never go off the road, you never let your mind wander. Anything could have happened to us that night in the desert. All because of a cup of tea.
My name is Anthony Cobb. I was a member of the 1st Cavalry in the Gulf War. The ceasefire was called on February 28, 1991. But shortly after returning home, many soldiers, including myself, started experiencing strange symptoms. Headaches, loss of concentration, nerve damage, and liver failure, to name a few. So, I traveled to Washington, along with my friend Manny, to try to testify in front of Congress to find some funding and research for this mystery illness labeled as
Gulf War syndrome.
The VA, they've been giving out pills to people.
I don't need pills! My foot's cut off, my toes still hurt. They don't have enough pills for that.
I'm truly sorry, but you won't get any funding for a war that's already over.
Ah! It's not over! It's not over! People are dying and you're doing nothing! You think about the homeless veterans, the divorced veterans, the suicidal veterans that are praying that God would just take them away. I can't even look at my wife anymore, man. The military has screwed with my brain. When you're a kid, you learn how to share, and love, and trust. We had that ripped away from us. I know how to survive. That's all I know how to do. So don't tell me it's over, because it's not.
Listen.
Shut up! You don't know what it's like. No one out there knows what it's like. They were just kids. They were just kids.
Gentlemen, this meeting is over. You can show yourself.
People think that this was the greatest military triumph. But for those of us who know the reality, we say that Saddam Hussein was the real winner of the war. He just wasn't alive to see it.
I feel like I can conquer anything.
Change you all will. You can go into battle with or without me now.
No, Colonel. I can't go into battle without you. I wouldn't feel safe.
Private, when in battle, it's all about your brothers. You have Jerry's back, and he has yours.
I have your six. Don't be worried, Luke.
Okay.
I guess we're going to have to get used to, well, not being used to what's going on around here.
That's true. You got to stay adaptable.
We've been hit. Sims, you okay?
Yeah, I'm fine.
You lost an entire side of the wheels. Fire in the hole.
Are you nuts? You can't blow it out with your own breath. I know there's a fire extinguisher around here somewhere.
Sorry.
Here. The second fire behind us is still moving.
On the line. I had to keep going. The men in that striker with me were gonna die. If they weren't already.
Hey, sir, there's a ditch just up ahead. If I flood the gas, we'll go straight there, right?
Yep. That's what you wanna do. Go for it. I'd hang on tightly if I were you.
Why?
Oh, you'll see.
What was that?
That was our Yankee getting us stuck in the ditch for the first time. Not too bad for your first time. Now, boys, get out.
I don't think we should let him drive the tank anymore.
I'd like to see you get behind the wheel of that monster.
Well, it won't get us stuck on cleaning duty all day.
Son, you get stuck on cleaning duty whether you're driving the tank or not. Besides, I can't think of anything more fun than flexing those muscles of yours and pushing the tank out of mud and scrubbing it down to perfection.
Yeah, right. Best day ever.
Hey, you can write your grandpa about your best day ever.
Oh, yeah. I'll be sure to write to him right after you take this for a spin.
Why write your grandpa?
Oh, it was a joke, sir. His grandpa's in the military. It's kind of a family tradition.
Yeah, like Foster here, was the first of his breed to venture out and join the army.
See? You wouldn't have known all that about each other if you hadn't been forced to work next to each other all day long. You're welcome.
Well, technically, we could have gotten to know each other in a more relaxed environment. Like the barracks.
Son, did you enlist in the Tea Party or the Army?